Welcome back. As if petrol prices haven't been high enough, more potential pain on the way. Russia banning oil exports to G7 countries, including Australia, in retaliation for sanctions introduced after the Ukraine invasion.
So what does this mean for Australia and the world? To discuss, we're joined by Tony Wood from the Grattan Institute. Tony, thanks for your time this morning. The big question is, how will this impact Aussies?
Well, it won't affect us directly. We don't buy our oil or our petrol from Russia directly. We've basically been one of those countries that have been banned by buying Russian oil products already. The issue is, how does this play out indirectly? And it remains to be seen, because gradually the West and Russia have been raising the stakes in what is becoming pretty very extended, drawn-out challenge associated with the Ukraine war. The implications are indirect. And we'll have to see what happens next. But, you know, it's certainly not getting any easier, that's for sure, for anybody.
I remember when Russia first invaded, all the analysis was that it was going to take a week for the Russians to take Kyiv. Obviously, that could not be more wrong. And as it drags out longer and longer, it all comes down to impacting the global supply of oil. So this move in particular, what impact is that going to have on global oil supply?
Well, I guess that's the key point here, is that both sides are trying to keep the pressure up, but they're also trying to make sure that they don't shut everything down. So the Russians are worried about their economy. They want to keep earning revenue from their exports. The West wants to put pressure on them without disrupting the whole oil system. And I guess the consequence we could see, and hard to tell yet, that by Russia banning these exports to certain countries could actually put more pressure on the global energy supply chain. That could mean that we end up with some shortages. That could also mean higher prices, as we've seen before. That's what Russia would, I guess, be wanting to say in the way they've imposed this ban. Equally, the West is trying to say, well, we're just going to continue to restrict your economy and put more pressure on you. How this plays out, it's hard to tell. That's the way it could affect us, because we import almost all of our crude and petrol products, mostly from Asia, some from the United States.
Tony, are these sanctions on Russia, though, really having any major impact?
It's really hard to tell. There's not much doubt that, broadly speaking, the Australian economy, the Russian economy is struggling with all this stuff. There's all sorts of reports on the ground from Russia as to how difficult it is for people living there. Obviously, the military side of it's bad as well, but this side of things, the sort of sanctions that the West has put on Russia is having an impact. Now, it's nowhere near as strong as some of the sanctions we've imposed on other countries for other things, but Russia is such an important part of the global system that it's hard to do both at the same time, that is, restrict Russia and maintain some degree of stability in the global energy system. So I'm sure it's having an impact, clearly not enough yet, and each time one side takes another step, the stakes rise, and at some point things will give. But I don't think it's going to happen anytime soon, because, as you said, Michael, this has been going on for a while.
OK,